Welcome to Smart Academy. We are giving CSI Physical Science online classes. Today our topic is operators. Already I discussed operators properties. So today I want to discuss different types of operators. Let us discuss the operators. Before going to discussion, please subscribe my channel Smart Academy. See, already I discussed operators. See, the properties already discussed here. So let us start with the energy operator. Energy operator. See, energy operator. According to Schrödinger, time independent wave equation. According to Schrödinger, time independent wave equation minus h cut square by 2m delta square plus v of psi equal to E sharp. So here you can say this one E sharp equal to say this one E sharp. So this one is here H sharp. Sorry. So we can call this one energy operator. Energy operator. See, this energy operator operated on aberrant psi. So we are getting E value and wave function. So here energy operator is h cut square by 2m delta square plus v. In Schrödinger time independent wave equation, energy operator is this one. So according to Schrödinger time dependent wave equation, according to Schrödinger time dependent wave equation equal to h psi equal to I h cut dou by dou t psi. Here this one we can say this is energy operator in time dependent wave equation. So finally energy operator equal to, so here I want to write here, finally energy operator equal to minus h cot square by 2m delta square plus v, that is equal to y h cut dou by 2t. So energy operator equal to this one. Remember very careful. See, energy operator equal to minus h cot square by 2m delta square plus v equal to I h cut dou by dou t. This is energy operator. So next we discuss momentum operator. Momentum operator. Second one, momentum operator. See here, second one, the Hamiltonian of the system, Hamiltonian of the system represents total energy of the system. Total energy. of the system, that is equal to Ke plus the kinetic energy plus potential energy, which is nothing but total energy. So we can represent with the Hamiltonian. So that is equal to Hamiltonian H equal to Ke plus P. That is equal to P square by 2m plus V. P square by 2m plus V. So here H equal to, we can write minus H cut square by 2m delta square plus P. So compared with P square by 2m plus V. So from this P square equal to, so this is momentum operator, that is equal to minus H cut square by 2m delta P square equal to P square by 2m equal to H cut square by delta square. So operator, momentum operator equal to, we can write H cut by I delta. This is momentum operator. This is also important. Momentum operator equal to H cut by I into delta. Okay. Otherwise we can write like this also, minus I H cut delta. So we can like this also, minus I H cut delta. This is the second momentum operator. So third one is kinetic energy operator. Third one is kinetic energy operator. Already we know that Hamiltonian equal to total energy, that is kinetic energy plus potential energy. So Hamiltonian, this operator equal to Ke, kinetic energy operator, potential energy operator. So Hamiltonian equal to minus H cut square by 2m delta square plus P. So compare here from these two. Kinetic energy operator equal to minus H cot square by 2m delta square. So this is the kinetic energy operator. So kinetic energy operator equal to minus H cot square by 2m into delta square. So here I want to discuss the fourth one, velocity operator. Velocity operator. So already we know kinetic energy operator equal to minus H cot square by 2m delta square is a velocity operator. Kinetic energy is nothing but half m v square. So half m v square equal to minus H cot square by 2m delta square. So multiply and divide with m, we get this one. So 2m 2m cancel. So we get minus H cot square by m square delta square. So velocity operator equal to H cut by im delta. This is the velocity operator. This is the kinetic energy operator. This is velocity operator. So today we discussed four operators here. So one more concept also is there. Again values and again functions. Again values and again functions. For example, if O be any operator, is operated on a wave function, you will get a constant and same wave function you will get. See here, see if you if O is any operator, operator operated on a wave function, we are getting a constant and same wave function. Here operator is operator, this is operator, lambda is eigen, we are calling eigen value. So when the operator operated on wave function, we are getting a constant. The constant is called eigen value. Then the wave function is eigen function. So this is a concept, eigen values and eigen functions. See, simply any operator operated on a wave function that gives a constant and same wave function. The constant is called eigenvalue. Then this wave function is called eigen function. This is operator. For example, sine 4x, psi equal to sine 4x. That is psi of x equal to sine 4x. This is a wave function, well-defined wave function. We are operating operator on sine 4x. D square by dx square, we are operating minus d square by dx square. This is the operator operating on wave function. So what is the value we are getting? Just check. See, minus d square by dx square sine 4x. First of all, d by dx, d by dx of sin x, first integration, 4 cos 4x. So repeated one more differentiation, you get minus minus plus 16 sin 4x. So that is equal to minus d square by dx sin 4x. So this is a wave function, this is a wave function. This is the operator. This value, the constant value we got here, this is eigen value. So this well-defined wave function, eigen function. This is simply, this is the operator, this is the eigen function. For the value we got here, that is eigen value, this is repeated, same wave function. So thank you.